NASA just opened up a capsule from space containing rock and dust collected from a 4.5 billion year old asteroid, and it may hold the secrets to how life began on Earth. This is all part of NASA's OSIRIS-REx sample return mission, which is the first US mission to collect a sample from an asteroid and return it safely back to Earth. The Japanese space agency, JAXA, has achieved this twice already by returning small samples from the asteroids Itokawa in 2010 and Ryugu in 2020. But the OSIRIS-REx mission stands out as the largest sample return of an asteroid conducted so far. The OSIRIS-REx spacecraft launched on an Atlas V rocket from Cape Canaveral on the 8th of September in 2016. After a little over 2 years, it arrived at the near-Earth asteroid Bennu and orbited around it, mapping its surface, almost casing it for the perfect sample collection spot. It took about a year for the mission team to select the ideal sample collection location, deciding on a site nestled in a crater high in Bennu's northern hemisphere called Nightingale. And then on October 20, 2020, OSIRIS-REx successfully booped the asteroid Bennu, collecting its sample and finally deposited that sample back to Earth safely on the 24th of September, 2023. But why the asteroid Bennu? Like, what makes it so special to be the target of the OSIRIS-REx mission? Well, there are three reasons. Reason number one, it is one of less than 200 near-Earth objects whose orbit is well known and quite similar to Earth's orbit. Bennu is characterized as an Apollo asteroid. These are asteroids whose orbits cross over the orbit of Earth. So, since the orbit of Bennu was well known, that made it much easier to track down, to send a probe toward and orbit around the asteroid, as well as nick a sample from it to study back here on Earth. Reason number two, Bennu is a relatively large asteroid, which makes it easier for spacecraft to visit because it doesn't spin as fast and it has more surface area to potentially collect samples from. And most importantly, reason number three, Bennu is rich in carbon-based materials. This makes it a very attractive target in the study of asteroids that may have delivered water and organic materials to Earth, potentially kickstarting life. NASA scientists have only just recently opened up the sample canister and were surprised to find bonus material outside the collection canister. It's for this reason that the initial curation process, the process of organizing and labeling the rocks and materials of the sample, happened more slowly than anticipated. A very important part of this mission is keeping this sample from Bennu clean and pristine so there's no potential contamination. And it's actually that bonus material that was used for this first look analysis. In this first look analysis, scientists used various instruments to investigate the sample, including a scanning electron microscope, which uses a focused beam of electrons to scan across the sample and generate really detailed images of the material. They also used infrared measurements, which provide valuable information on whether the sample contained hydrated minerals and organic-rich particles. And finally, they also used X-ray diffraction, which makes use of high-energy X-ray light to scatter off the material. This X-ray diffraction is sensitive to different minerals, and by using this to analyze the asteroid sample, it provided an inventory of the materials and minerals contained inside the sample. So what did they find in this asteroid sample? Well, from this first look analysis, they found that the sample is riddled with carbon and water. Those are the most basic ingredients for life on Earth. This means that this sample of Bennu will help scientists investigate where life on Earth came from. Here are the main results from the scanning electron microscope. These images show different types of minerals and materials contained within the sample. The top left panel shows clay minerals that have water locked inside them. This is how we think water actually got to Earth, through minerals like this from asteroids like Bennu. In the top right is a hexagon sulfide mineral. These minerals are a critical element in the evolution of planets, dictating how quickly things melt, and they're also crucial to amino acids that give structure to proteins. And the bottom two panels show magnetite, a mineral made of iron and oxygen. One particle looks like a raspberry, and the other looks more plate-like. And apparently, these plate-like magnetite minerals could also be important for organic evolution in certain reactions. This next clip shows the computer model generated from X-ray diffraction for one of the largest pieces of rock in the bonus material, measuring around 2 millimeters in diameter. This sort of computer modeling is really important because it gives scientists a detailed map of what's on the inside of the material, allowing them to slice it up in the most useful way for further analysis. And finally, check this out. This is an image of a grain from the sample, both in visible light on the left and under UV light on the right. See all of those white specks that kind of look like stars? Those bright specks are organic matter. This is just incredible. And this is just the beginning. Like I said before, this initial first look is just of the bonus material outside the collection canister. Data curation of the material inside the canister is just getting underway. Over the next 6 months, the curation team and the science team from the OSIRIS-REx mission will work closely together to develop a sample catalogue of all the dust, grains, and small rocks collected from asteroid Bennu. Once that sample catalogue is released, scientists from around the world will be able to request samples of Bennu to study in their own labs. And this is my favourite part. At least 70% of the entire sample collected will be available for present and future scientists to study for decades to come. And additional samples will be loaned for public display at the Smithsonian Institute, Space Center Houston, and the University of Arizona. So we could go see it. A 4.5 billion year old asteroid sample in pristine condition, in person, with our own eyes. Who's up for an Astrocursed and field trip? But the mission doesn't end there, not even when the science team completes the science mission objectives within the next couple of years. No, because as soon as the Bennu sample was delivered to Earth, the OSIRIS-REx mission was renamed to OSIRIS-APEX, aka OSIRIS Apophis Explorer. You know what that means? Extended mission time! So the newly renamed OSIRIS-APEX mission will be redirected to the Apophis asteroid, another near-Earth asteroid, to closely study the asteroid and the changes in its orbit that will be inflicted by a close encounter with Earth in 2029, as well as study some of its material as well. Stay tuned for more updates on the science of the OSIRIS-REx and the ongoing OSIRIS-APEX mission right here at Astrocursed.